MRI evaluation of the brain tumors. Myself, Dr. Kajal Patel, third year resident doctor, Department of the Radiodiagnosis from Surat Municipal Institute of Medical Education and Research. Special thanks to my co-authors, Dr. Paresh Patel, Dr. Jigar Aiyya, Dr. Ekta Desai, Dr. Nehal Divanji, Dr. Nirav Kadwani. Introduction. MRI plays a major role in diagnosis, grading, treatment, and treatment response assessment of brain tumor and other intracranial lesion. Conventional MRI provides the anatomical and structural detail of the lesion in neuraxis. Roughly 1/3 are CNS tumor are metastatic lesion, 1/3 are glioma, and 1/3 is of non-glial origin. Glioma is a non-specific term indicating that the tumor originates from the glial cell like the astrocyte, oligodendrocyte, ependymal, and the choroid plexus cells. Astrocytoma is the most common glioma and subdivided into the low-grade pilocytic, intermediate anaplastic, and the high-grade malignant glioblastoma multiform. Glioblastoma multiform is the most common type, 50% of all the astrocytoma. Non-glial cell tumor are large heterogeneous group of tumor of which meningioma is the most common. Aims and objective: MRI evaluation of the lesion and its extent and establishment of the radiological diagnosis. To evaluate the role of MRI, aided with the contrast enhanced MRI as an imaging modality for the diagnosis of the brain tumor. Materials and the method. Observational study was carried out on 32 patients during the study period of 1.5 years. Inclusion criteria: only those patients willing to participate in the study were included. Brain tumor detected on contrast MR study were taken, and cases of all the age group irrespective of the sex. Exclusion criteria: patient not willing to participate in the study, patient having history of the claustrophobia, patient having the contraindication to the MRI. The MRI scan was performed on 1.5 Tesla MR Philip Echeverria during the dedicated head coil. Conventional spin echo sequence, axial T1, T2 and flare, coronal T2, sagittal T1, post contrast axial, coronal and sagittal, and diffusion weighted imaging and GRE is taken. Contrast enhanced scan was performed using the gadolinium DTPA. Observation and the result. The most common age group involved is a 41 to 50 year of age group, and the distribution of the patient according to type of the lesion. Out of 32 patients, the maximum number of cases, 8 cases are of metastatic brain lesion, followed by the meningioma, which are of the 6 patient. And distribution of the patient according to the symptoms. There are various symptoms like the headache, seizures, vertigo, vomiting, tinnitus, endocrine changes. 11 patient, maximum number of patients are presenting with a headache. Discussion of the cases. First one is a pilocytic astrocytoma. 15-year-old male patient, solid cystic infratentorial lesion which is seen involving the left cerebellar hemisphere. Cystic component appear hyperintense to the CSF on all pulse sequences with no enhancement on the post-contrast study. Eccentric mural nodule, solid nodule component which show heterogeneous intermediate to hyperintense signal on T2 weighted images and flare images, and isointense on T1 weighted images with heterogeneous enhancement on post-contrast study. Multiple area of the phloid seen on the GRE imaging within the mural nodule component may represent the calcification or the vascular phloid. Second one is a medulloblastoma. 7-year-old male patient, well demarcated T1 hypointense, T2 and flare heterogeneously hyperintense lesion. We show heterogeneous peripheral enhancement noted involving the fourth ventricle with resultant hydrocephalus as showing above. Glioma. 45-year-old male patient, a well-defined T1 hypointense, T2 and flare hyperintense lesion which show few internal blooming with no diffusion restriction and vivid post-contrast enhancement noted involving the left parietal lobe compressing the left lateral ventricle. Intraventricular central neurocytoma. 30-year-old male patient, the solid cystic lesion seen involving left lateral ventricle, cystic component medially appear hyperintense on T2 weighted images and attenuated partly on the flare images and hypointense on the T1 weighted images. Solid component show heterogeneous hypo to hyperintense signal on T2 weighted image and flare images, and isotope patchy hypointense signal on T1 weighted images with heterogeneous enhancement on the post contrast study with peripheral blooming on GRE images. No evidence of the diffusion restriction is noted. Craniopharyngioma. 43-year-old female patient, a well demarcated T1 hypointense, T2 and flare hyperintense intracellular lesion noted which show internal few area of the blooming and vivid post contrast enhancement. Hypothalamic hematoma. 10-year-old male patient, well defined lesion noted in the interpedicular and prepontine cistern which appear isointense on T1 weighted images and hyper intense on T2 and flare images with no diffusion restriction, no area of the blooming noted, no post contrast enhancement. Posteriorly, the lesion compressing the basilar artery and displacing it toward the right side. Superiorly, the lesion involving the hypothalamic area. Metastasis. 59-year-old male patient with known case of carcinoma of prostate, multiple small variable size cortical and subcortical white matter homogeneously enhancing lesions which are hypointense on the T1 images and hyperintense on the T2 flare images noted with heterogeneous ring enhancement on the post contrast T1 weighted images. The metastatic lesion noted involving left thalamus, right temporal lobe, bilateral parietal lobe, pons, middle cerebellar peduncle and the cerebellum. Meningioma. 45-year-old female patient, well-defined T1 isointense, T2 and flare hyperintense lesion which show homogeneous post-contrast enhancement noted involving the right cerebellar hemisphere. Glioblastoma multiforme. 66-year-old male patient, a large well-demarcated T1 hypointense, T2 and flare hyperintense lesion with surrounding vasogenic edema with internal flow voids noted and the lesion show intermediate diffusion restriction on DWI ADC sequences and irregular ring enhancement on post contrast images. The lesion noted involving the left parietotemporal region. Lymphoma. 65-year-old HIV positive female, multiple well-demarcated T1 hypointense, T2 and flare hyperintense lesion which show diffusion restriction and peripheral ring enhancement with notch sign. Present the lesion noted involving the left periventricular white matter in the left parietal lobe and exhibit the subependymal extension and crossing the corpus callosum. Pituitary macroadenoma with hemorrhage. 30-year-old female patient, a large well-demarcated cellular and supracellular lesion noted which appear heterogeneously hypointense on T1 image, hyperintense on T2 and flare images, and the lesion show heterogeneous post-contrast enhancement within the and there is a fluid level noted within the lesion with a blooming on the posterior part of the lesion on GRE may suggest the hemorrhage within the lesion and the lesion is forming the typical figure of 8 sign. Conclusion. One of the most important advantage of MRI is influence of the multiple tissue and machine parameters on the signal intensity. In addition, capability of the imaging in various planes and multi-slice is another advantage for the brain tumor diagnosis. I discuss MRI is superior to CT in many brain tumor, but poor delineation of the calcification and hemorrhage is the disadvantage of MRI. Take home messages. Lesion with the vasogenic edema should also demonstrate contrast enhancement. Solitary deep lesions are most likely to be the primary glioma. Round nodular lesions at the gray-white matter junction are more likely to be metastatic. And notch sign, which is abnormality of the deep depression at the tumor margin on the contrast enhanced MRI, is a specific feature for the primary CNS lymphoma. Diffuse glioma affects the cortex, vasogenic edema does not. And extra axial lesions are meningioma, schwannoma, and congenital cyst. Thank you.